The first gospel reading this morning comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 11 and 12. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And the second reading is from James 1, 19 through 27, hearing and doing the word. You must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen, slow to speak, slow to anger. For your anger does not produce God's righteousness. Therefore, rid yourself of all sordidness and rank growth of wickedness, and welcome with meekness the implanted word that has the power to save your souls. But be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror. For they look at themselves and on going away immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not hearers who forget, but doers who act, they will be blessed in their doing. If any, they are righteous, religious, and do not bridle their tongues, but deceive their hearts, their religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this: to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
So we're in our second week of our series called Lyrical Lessons from Unexpected Prophets, and this week is a song that was written and performed by Michael Jackson called Man in the Mirror. It continues with our theme of looking for spiritual messages in unexpected places. And let's watch the music video for this one, and then we'll jump into the message.
Change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. As I turn up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street. Not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them need? A summer's disregard, a broken bottle top, and one man's soul. They follow each other on the wind, you know, 'cause they got nowhere to go. That's why no one yet to know.
There comes a time in each and every one of our lives that we need to take a look at where we are and what we do. We need to continually examine ourselves and ask the question, am I doing my best to serve God? A lot of us, when asking this question, see things in ourselves that we wish we could change. We have feelings, thoughts, problems, attitudes that we know we need to change. Everybody here continue to take a look at themselves and realize there is something in our lives that is not the way that we want it to be. We need to make a conscious effort to make a change in the way we walk, the way we talk, the way we think, and the way we act. We need to make a change for the better. We need to take on the attitude that the time is now for a new me. Time for me to give my all to God. It is time that we make a change for the betterment of us all. If we're going to make things better for any of us, any type of change, it must begin with us. It is said that a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. We need to make sure that we are not the weakest link in our lives. So many times we're able to see the tiny faults that others have. We see that speck or that splinter in their eye and miss out on the log that is in our own. To put it plain and simple, we must be, as Michael Jackson said, start with the man in the mirror. We must begin with ourselves, the one that we see every day, and ask them to change their ways. If every one of us changed something about ourselves that we know is not a good trait, what a wonderful place this world would be. If every one of us started with the man in the mirror, we wouldn't have time to find fault in others. We wouldn't have time to find fault in another because we would be too busy taking care of our own faults. Now, I want to show you a quick video clip right now of one of my favorite Christian comedians, Mark Lowry. He happens to also be a great gospel artist, sang with the Gaither Vocal Band. You may know the song Mary Did You Know from Christmas. Mark is the author of that song in the original recorder, but here's a bit he does kind of on that theme of taking care of ourselves and not looking for the wrong in others.
But he was always hanging around the outcast, y'all. And you know what? That's who we were. If that sheet hadn't fallen, remember Peter in Acts chapter 10 when that sheet fell out of the sky? All his life he'd been told through his scriptures that we were the outcast, we were the uncircumcised Philistines and freaks and Gentiles, you know. And all of a sudden, he'd never had a pork chop between his lips. And all of a sudden, this sheet falls out of the sky, and he sees all these animals he's not supposed to eat. And God said, get up and kill and eat. He said, oh, no, Lord, I can't do that. And you know, because that sheet fell, we got invited into the kingdom of God. We would not even know about God if it hadn't been for that sheet falling. Because he came unto his own, and his own received him not. Thank God they didn't receive him, or we'd still be out on the outside looking in. But because they would not receive him, God opened up the doors and said, go out in the byways and the highways and compel them to come in. And that's how we got in. And now it seems like after 2,000 years, the uninvited guests are standing at the door keeping other uninvited guests out. I say, throw the doors open and let them in. And you know what else? I didn't make a very good fundamentalist because I never figured out how do you love the sinner and hate the sin? There's too many of you. I ain't got time to hate your sin. Hate your own sin. Hating my sin is a full-time job. The psalmist said, my sin is ever before me. I don't have time to hate. I think it should be this. Love the sinner and hate your own sin. You hate your sin, I'll hate my sin, and let's love each other. You Baptists love the Pentecostals, Nazarenes, because Jesus did. Remember that woman at the well? She'd been married 5 times. Beat that. You know, and he went in the middle of the day to meet her. Remember that? All the respectable women came early in the morning. But since he had no time for respectable women, because he knew they didn't need him and they didn't want him, he knew that woman who'd been married 5 times was going to be there that afternoon. And he showed up.
That line that he says, hate your own sin. I'll hate mine, you hate yours, and let's love one another. That's at the heart of the message that we heard in the song, that we hear in the lesson today from James, that we need to be doers of the word, not merely hearers of the word. It's about starting with the man in the mirror, that once we see what's wrong, we understand that change needs to be made. When we look in the mirror, it reflects back on a true image of what and who we are. Think about how you prepare to go out on your day. I'm going to guess not one of us doesn't look at the mirror at least once before we leave the house each day, whether we're going to work or some other activity. We do it because it gives us the opportunity to see if something is not right. Our hair's out of place. Maybe we see a stain on our shirt we didn't see before. We need to tuck our shirt in differently, whatever it may be. We do it so that we can correct something that's not the way we want it. But you see, we need to do the same thing with our own lives and our spiritual lives. We need to look into the mirror of our spirituality and see what may not be on the right track. See that maybe our shirt isn't ironed enough to go to that big event. The mirror enables us to see if there's anything out of place and gives us the opportunity to correct the problem. In James, it tells us that we are to not merely be hearers of the word, but doers of the word. We need to live it out. It's not enough to, excuse me, it's not enough for us just to read the word and spend time daily in devotion, but if we never internalize it, if we never take it in and do something with it, nothing's going to change. Nothing will change in our lives. Nothing will change in the community around us, in our families, in our country, in our world. If those first disciples after Jesus' crucifixion decided to just continue to tell the stories they already knew to one another, nothing would have ever happened with Christianity. If they had not been doers of the word from the very beginning, we wouldn't be here today. We wouldn't have the opportunity to mess up everything and fix it ourselves if they hadn't done what they needed to do from the beginning. And if we are not doers of the word now, the mission of Christ's church will be diminished greatly. I think about through Scripture and a character in the Bible that gives us the best example of screwing up and working to change their life is none other than King David. One only has to look at his journey through the Old Testament and then turn to the Psalms and all the Psalms that are credited to David's writing. If you all didn't know it, David's a messed up individual. We tend to lift up biblical heroes and think of them at only the perfect things they do, but here's the catch. God uses messed up people over and over again in the history of the world to further God's mission. David was no different. David made lots and lots of bad choices. He let power get to his head at times. He went after his own interests instead of those of his people time and time again. But he always seemed to come around and realize that he had a problem. And it was more than just saying, oh, I shouldn't have done that. Go through the Psalms, spend some time in his laments. He talks about the need for God to wash over him, to cleanse him of the things he does wrong. Not simply take a quick bath, but a deep cleaning of his soul. He realized, after examining his life, a change needed to happen. Jesus realized it was not enough to just blot out his sin, but he needed to be washed through and through. He acknowledges his transgressions, but too many times we try to hide our bad traits. We don't want to reveal them to our family and our friends, or even to ourselves. But in order for us to be changed, we must admit when we fall short. We must admit not only to others, but also to ourselves. Even though half the times others already know our faults and the things we've done, we refuse to see it ourselves. It's like dealing with a friend or family member that has an addiction. Until they're willing to admit they have the addiction themselves, there's nothing you can do to help them. Because some changes are so monumental in your lives, you have to acknowledge it yourself. I've seen it happen time and time again. Families try to help someone in their midst that isn't ready for the help. And it seems like maybe short term there's a change. But they've not internally admitted that the change needed to happen and don't make it part of their life. And you see, it's not just a one-time thing either. We have to, every morning, wake up and look in that mirror. Every day, we have to say, I'm going to continue this change in my life. This day is going to be another day where I make a turn in the right direction. It's not simply a one-and-done type of thing. You see, our spiritual journey is lifelong. So often, our culture has taught us, especially if you've maybe come to Christianity later in life, that you accept Christ, you say this magical prayer, and your life will change forever. Well, it will. But you have to continue to grow and change. You have to be willing to spend the time to look in that mirror, to see what God is pointing out to you, what God is calling you forward to do in your life. You see, David wanted to be new and improved, and so do we. He wanted to be as perfect of a servant of God as he could be. And you see, we have examples like David trying to get his life together. We have that throughout the Old Testament. In the New Testament, we have the examples of Paul in all his writings. Paul also was not the perfect individual. Paul spent the early part of his life persecuting the early Christians, wanting them imprisoned and killed because they didn't follow the religious rules of the day. But Paul had that experience on the road to Damascus that showed him the need for change in his life. Paul saw something when his sight was taken from him, to see and hear more clearly what God had in store for him. And then the ultimate lesson we are given in Scripture, in the New Testament, is the life of Christ Jesus, who showed us it is possible to live in this world and to do all the things that God calls us to do, to make the changes. But it also shows us those changes aren't easy. Those changes can cost us everything for the good of God. We should be about the business of being doers of the word. As we hear at the end of Matthew, we are to go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them all the things that Christ has commanded us. And we're told that he is with us, even to the end of the earth. Too many times we get wrapped up in our own ways, that we forget about the ways of the one who we serve. The best way to teach others is to set a good example. A good example is better than any words that we can say. If we take a good look at the man in the mirror, and truly decide to change what we see, we need to start making that commitment now. Let us commit to love one another. Let us commit to work harder for God. Instead of waiting for somebody else to do something when something needs to be done, let us pick up the ball ourselves and run with it. Instead of waiting for someone to ask for help and we watch them fall flat on their face, let us volunteer to help them out before that fall has to happen. Instead of talking about one another, ruining their name and running it into the ground, let us talk with one another. Instead of running each other down, let us pick each other up. Instead of criticizing each other's ideas, let us come up with some of our own. Instead of finding faults in others, let us start with the man in the mirror. Let's ask that reflection we see in the mirror to make a change, and to be changed by God. Jesus shows us the power to change the man in the mirror. Jesus shows us the power to make a new creation. Jesus has the power to make us better than we were before. Michael Jackson was right when he said in the song, "We've got to get it right while we have the time. Tomorrow is not promised to us. Yesterday is already gone. All we have is here and now." If we start with the man in the mirror, we can start to make the world a better place, one person at a time. If we start with the man in the mirror, then we can begin to make this community the one that God wants it to be. If we start with the man in the mirror, then we won't have time to worry about fixing someone else. If we start with the man in the mirror and let God make the changes, we become a new creation ourselves. We will come out with a clean heart. We'll come out with a renewed spirit. We will come with restored joy. We'll come with pure satisfaction. If we take a good look at the man in the mirror and see the changes that need to be made, our lives and our world can be totally different. We can take a good look at the man in the mirror and see what will make him better. We can take a good look at the man in the mirror and ask God to take control. Take a good look at the man in the mirror and let them be led by God. Take a good look at the man in the mirror and change him before trying to change anybody else. Take a good look at the man in the mirror and make that image the best that it can be. Our homes, our jobs, our churches, our community, and our world could be a better place if everyone would start by looking in the mirror and making the change there first. Amen.
Please join in the song of reflection, "Make Me a Servant," number 2176 in the songbook.